The key to understanding any electrical system is the single line drawing, also called a one line drawing or single line diagram. This drawing takes all three phases of power and all equipment in the system and simplifies the power flow into one easy to understand drawing. Each piece of equipment or component is represented by a specific symbol or abbreviation, with lines drawn between them to represent the conductors connecting the equipment together. This is one of many types of electrical drawings associated with power systems. You may also hear about three-line drawings, elevations, or control schematics. The focus here is the single-line drawing. The single line is important because when we are in a room full of electrical equipment, there's no way to tell how power flows just by looking at the equipment. The key to understanding how power flows is reading single line drawings and keeping them up to date for safety and design considerations. A single line drawing is typically read from top to bottom or left to right. If the system is fed by utility power, look for a downward arrow, utility transformer, or reference to a utility connection to signal the start of the system. From there, you can follow the lines downstream to the loads, likely passing through several pieces of electrical distribution equipment along the way. There are dozens of symbols that are commonly found in electrical distribution single line drawings. Let's start with the basics and then look at an example system. First, we have a transformer symbol. It looks like two coils or sometimes overlapping circles. Transformers are used to change the voltage levels in an electrical system. You may notice a triangle or a symbol that looks like the letter Y along either side of the transformer. A triangle represents a transformer connected in delta, where all three phases are connected to one another, which resembles a triangle. A Y represents a transformer connected such that one end of each phase is connected to form a common neutral point, which resembles a Y. There are two types of circuit opening devices commonly found on single lines: switches and circuit breakers. The switch symbol looks like a simple break in the conductor and represents switching devices that can open or close a circuit, typically through manual operation. A switch symbol may represent a medium voltage load interrupter switch, a low voltage safety switch, or perhaps a panel board with fusible switches as disconnect devices. We can check the text notes around the switch for clues about what type of equipment it is. The switch symbol may be accompanied by a rectangle with two lines or by opposing connected semicircles. These symbols represent a set of fuses. Fuses provide overcurrent protection to the system. Keep in mind, though we're only showing one fuse, a single line drawing represents a complete set of three fuses, one for each of the three phases. A circuit breaker symbol can look a few different ways depending on the type and voltage level. A circuit breaker may be represented by a simple square for a medium voltage breaker, or by an arch bridging a gap in the conductor for a low voltage breaker. A drawout circuit breaker symbol represents a breaker that can be removed from its enclosure for maintenance or replacement without disturbing the wiring of the equipment. Drawout capability is typically represented by two carrots or chevrons above and below the circuit breaker. The abbreviation DO, indicating drawout, may also be noted. Drawout breakers are commonly used in applications where frequent maintenance or testing is required. On the other hand, fixed-mounted circuit breakers are permanently installed in their enclosure. Fixed-mounted breaker symbols do not include any additional carrots or chevrons. Fixed-mounted breakers are used in applications where the breaker does not need to be frequently accessed for maintenance. When looking for circuit breakers, always keep an eye out for the number 52 on the single line. This is the ANSI device number for a circuit breaker and is often used as an abbreviation. It is one of many abbreviations designated by ANSI standards used on electrical drawings. In addition to sources, transformers, and circuit opening devices, it's always important to look for any ground symbols. The ground symbol is crucial for safety as it represents the point where the electrical system is connected to ground. The ground symbol looks like a series of horizontal lines that get shorter as they go down. This symbol indicates a connection to the earth, which helps protect the system from electrical faults. Now that we have identified the basic symbols on a single line, let's look at an example power system. Here, you can see an incoming 13.8 kV utility feed labeled incoming utility. This incoming utility feed is connected to a medium voltage switch that includes a disconnect switch and 60 amp fuse. The load side of the fuse is then connected to the primary side of a 13.8 kV to 480 277 volt transformer with rating of 1000 kVA. Next, the secondary side of the 1000 kVA transformer feeds a 1600 amp draw out main breaker and a variety of fixed mounted feeder breakers, each serving a load. Notice that the main breaker and feeder breakers are enclosed in a rectangle. The rectangle, which may be a solid or dashed line, denotes that these items are all within one piece of equipment, labeled with a designation as shown. You will find this designation on the equipment in the field. In this example, this piece of equipment is a switchboard. The horizontal line between the main and feeder breakers is the bus within the switchboard. The bus distributes power from the load side of the main breaker to the line side of the feeder breakers. Within the rectangle representing the switchboard, we will also find notations of the voltage, amperage, and short circuit rating. Downstream of the switchboard, two types of loads are shown. First, an M within a circle represents a motor load. Another clue that this is a motor load can be found in the nearby text, which labels the M with a horsepower rating. And second, a labeled rectangle that may represent just about any type of load. Look for text nearby to identify exactly what it is. In this case, our load is described as a unit heater, which is a type of resistive load. Now that we've explored the basics, let's dive into some more complex details. Circuit breaker symbols often include a lot of additional notes and abbreviations that describe how the breaker operates. Low voltage breakers include integral trip units in one of several types. TM indicates the breaker has an integral thermal magnetic trip unit. ET, LS, LSI, or LSIG indicate the breaker has an integral electronic trip unit. The L, S, I, and G refer to the types of protection provided by the trip unit: long, short, instantaneous, and ground. Not every electronic trip unit provides every type of protection. The circuit breaker may also note ARMS protection is to be included. ARMS stands for Arc Flash Reduction Maintenance System. Including ARMS as an option with an electronic trip unit provides a maintenance mode switch that when activated will trip the breaker faster than the programmable instantaneous setting at the first sign of a fault, protecting workers that may be working downstream. Low voltage insulated case or power breakers may be mechanically or electrically operated, and this may be indicated on the drawing. Mechanically operated breakers can only be opened by the integral trip unit or opened or closed by a person interacting with the front of the breaker, and may be indicated by the designation MO for manually operated. Electrically operated breakers include a shunt trip, allowing the breaker to be opened from an external signal, and a spring release, allowing the breaker to be closed from an external signal. The external signal may come from a push button, control switch, or other protective device. Electrically operated breakers may be indicated by the designation EO. Medium voltage breakers do not usually have integral trip units and rely on protective relays for overcurrent protection. A protective relay may be indicated by a two-digit number within a circle. This two-digit number is a reference to the ANSI device number corresponding to the function the relay performs. For example, a circle noting 50/51 indicates the breaker is protected by a protective relay performing function 50, instantaneous overcurrent, and function 51, time delay overcurrent. The protective relay may also be shown by a rectangle with the model number of the relay to be used. This example shows an Eaton EDR5000 protective relay. For more detail on protective relays, see our video on the basics of protective relaying. You will notice the 50/51 notation is connected to the main circuit through two half circles end to end with a line extending from the center. This is a current transformer, or CT. The CT takes line current and transforms it to a lower amperage to be safely read by devices like protective relays and meters. The CT ratio may be noted on the single line as well. This is the ratio of line current to CT secondary current. Similarly, you may see relays or meters fed by a smaller version of the transformer symbol we discussed earlier. This is a voltage transformer, or VT, also called a potential transformer, or PT. Its function is like the current transformer, but for voltage. The VT takes line voltage and transforms it to a lower voltage to be safely read by devices like protective relays or meters. Speaking of meters, a power meter may be shown with an enclosed M for meter or PM for power meter, extending from a CT or PT, similar to a protective relay. We need to be careful here as we already discussed an encircled M in context of a motor load. If the M is fed from CTs, it is a power meter. If the M is directly connected to the load side of distribution equipment, it is likely a motor. A meter may also be shown as a V, indicating voltage metering, or an A, indicating current metering. Systems with motor loads may use specific equipment to control them, which may reside in a motor control center, often abbreviated MCC, or in a standalone enclosure. Look for these items just upstream of a motor load. Parallel lines perpendicular to the bus represent a contactor. A contactor is a device used to switch an electrical circuit on or off, electrically or mechanically. The parallel lines represent the contactor's contacts in the open position. A contactor can open and close a circuit, but does not provide overcurrent or overload protection. An overload relay is noted by two linked broken semicircles or a block labeled OL. An overload relay protects motors from overheating due to prolonged overcurrent conditions called overloads. This is different than a circuit breaker trip unit, which provides shorter-term short circuit protection as well as overload protection. A contactor in series with an overload relay represents a combination starter. In this example, we see a full voltage non-reversing starter. The starter may be labeled FVNR on the single line and may include a switch or circuit breaker disconnect upstream of the contactor. For reduced voltage starting, you may see the abbreviation RVSS. You may also find a variable frequency drive, or VFD, on the single line. This symbol is often a rectangle with a wave symbol inside, or the letters VFD. A VFD is a device that controls the speed and torque of an electric motor by varying the frequency and voltage of its power supply. There are also some additional components we should be on the lookout for. In addition to utility sources, it is important single lines also show both permanent generators and provisions for temporary generator hookup. Generators are usually depicted as a circle with a G inside. The transfer switch symbol indicates a device used to switch the power supply from one source to another, often to and from a utility source and a generator source. It is typically shown as a rectangle with two inputs and one output, and lines indicating the switching action. It is likely to be labeled ATS for automatic transfer switch. A surge protective device, also called a transient voltage surge suppressor, abbreviated SPD or TVSS, represents a low voltage electrical device used to protect equipment from voltage spikes. It is usually depicted as a rectangle with a lightning bolt or the letters SPD inside. A surge arrestor or lightning arrestor symbol represents a medium voltage electrical device used to protect equipment from voltage spikes. It is usually depicted as a lightning bolt symbol or a series of parallel lines with the letters SA or LA. The capacitor symbol indicates a device used for power factor correction. It may be shown as two parallel lines with a gap between them, or one straight line and one arch with a gap between them, both representing the capacitor plates. This symbol often gets confused with the contactor symbol as they look similar. The resistor symbol indicates a device used to limit the flow of electrical current. It is typically shown as a zigzag line. An inductor or reactor may be shown in front of a VFD and looks like half of a transformer with a single winding connected in line with a drive. An indicating light symbol represents a device used to provide visual indication of the status of an electrical circuit. It is usually depicted as a circle with lines indicating illumination. There is often a letter inside the circle showing the color of the light. Let's walk through a more complicated single line from Eaton's Basics of Power Systems Design Guide. We'll start at the utility and work our way down. Our goal will be to understand how power flows to switchboard DSB-DF4A. We can see that the utility power comes in at 13.8 kV from utility feeder number 1. It comes into medium voltage switchgear USG-1A, which has 1200 amp bus. The power flows through this medium voltage breaker, labeled 52-M1, which is protected by an EDR5000 feeder protection relay using CTs and PTs. The power flows to the primary side of transformer T1. Transformer T1 is 7,500 kVA. It transforms the power from 13.8 kV to 4160 on the secondary side and is protected by an ETR5000 transformer protection relay via CTs on each side of the transformer. From the secondary side of transformer T1, the power flows into medium voltage switchgear lineup PSG-1A. This switchgear lineup is 4160 and has 2000 amp bus. You can see there are several different breakers in this lineup. It's larger than the 13.8 kV lineup upstream, as it includes a main breaker labeled 52S1 and three feeder breakers labeled 52F1, F2, and F3. Each breaker in the 4160 volt lineup has CTs feeding an EDR3000 relay, a control switch, and red, green, and amber indicating lights. When illuminated, the red light indicates the breaker is closed, the green light indicates the breaker is open, and the amber light indicates the breaker has tripped due to a fault on the system. This is the standard color scheme for power systems. Red means the circuit breaker is closed and power is on, and we need to stop and take caution. This is the opposite of what many may anticipate. Let's keep following the power flow. Feeder M1-02 extends onto the next page. Where multiple pages of drawings are linked together, there will be an indication of how the pages are linked. The 4160 volt feeder from the previous page matches up with feed A into CUP-F1A. This is the medium voltage switch on the other side of the room. This medium voltage switch is close coupled to transformer ST-F1A. This transformer steps the voltage down from 4160 to 480-277. Notice how all of these rectangles are adjacent to one another? That likely indicates the equipment is close coupled, which means it is directly bus connected instead of cable connected. From the secondary side of the transformer, it feeds SUS-F1A. This is low voltage switchgear, which we can identify as all of the breakers shown are drawout. This switchgear has multiple incoming sources, including the main breaker and a generator. The feeder breaker in 2D directly feeds the main breaker of DSB-DF4A. Now we understand how power flows to DSB-DF4A. Your first look at a single line diagram may be overwhelming, but once you break it down into the individual components, as we did in this example, it can be easy to understand. To learn more about power systems and see this equipment in action, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to one of Eaton's Power Systems Experience Centers today.